quicker. Yeah. Hottest on the planet, got the place lit up. Yeah. Fly, got expensive taste, sight enter. Yeah. We ain't on the same team, cheer up. Yeah. Bunch of that make sit up. I ain't come to blend in, boy, I stand out. Yeah. Money talks, you just popping off at the mouth. If I'm the topic, then the conversation hit it. Right shrimp, getting booked up in every city. Splash out with cash, had the spaz on the waiter. She messed up my order 3 times in a row. Whoa. I'm good on gas, I just filled up my tank. Now let's fill up her head and let's see if she goes.
We set the roof on fire. 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 We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire.
Slow. So bad, bad swimming in my bed. Off with it. Off with it. Young Slim, get it in my infrared. Come and hit the pool. Rain, I just lit the gas. Clean. Young wild winning, living fast. Stash your money in a brown paper bag. We set the roof on fire, then we flood it out. We just threw the money up, we ain't even count. Shake it. Shake it in my speeder, girl, I'm booting. Nothing. Pressing up my speech. I'm $1 million player, baby, nothing's at my reach. I'm $1 million, like I hit the lottery. Splash her with cash, had the spaz on the waitress. She messed up my order 3 times in a row. I'm good on gas, I just filled up my tank. Now let's fill up her head and let's see if she goes.
We set the roof on fire. 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 We set the roof on fire.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Rivers' Chargers going up against Manning's Giants. With that, let's get up to MetLife Stadium in New Jersey as we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the San Diego Chargers and the New York Giants. Come out with one back and three tight ends. To throw is Rivers. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off by Janoris Jenkins. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. After the INT, it's Manning. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Here we go now with a look at the offensive starters for the New York football Giants.
And Rashad Jennings, a running back, seventh-round pick when he came out, people tended to overlook him a little bit. But the last half of 2015, when he got the ball full-time, he showed his wares. Over 800 yards, he definitely has a 1,000-yard season in his future.
Another solid performance for OBJ in Week 12. Two more touchdowns, 96 yards. So tough to cover.
And there's no way that I look down my nose at a 96-yard day. But what we come to expect out of OBJ is well over 100 yards to go along with two touchdowns. To me, it just shows how efficient he is as a route runner. Doesn't have to be a big play. It can be intermediate, short plays, it doesn't matter. The way he competes for the ball is something else. And did you catch his touchdown celebrations this past Sunday?
I did.
Paying homage to a Cleveland icon.
And now a peek at the starters on the defensive side. Now Manning throwing on second down to Shepard, complete over the middle. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Perryman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Against the Texans, Henry had a touchdown grab, and that brings us to our point about an interesting nugget that you dug up, partner.
For the year, he has 5 touchdown catches. That's the same number as all the other rookie tight ends in the NFL combined. Now you understand why many people talk about him being a first-round draft choice, end up going in the second. He has really made his mark, and they think he's only going to get better and better, teamed up with Phillip Rivers and Antonio Gates in San Diego.
And Charles, here's the offensive lineup.
Melvin Gordon, the exciting young runner out of Wisconsin, well over 2,000 yards his last year with the Badgers. This is a guy who can catch it and run it.
And I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on 3rd and 1. Throwing Rivers. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. 13 yards that time and a first. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
And we look now at the defense for the Giants.
Landon Collins is built like your typical tackle-first safety, but he does have the ability to play the deep part of the field.
Here's Rivers, and it's complete to Antonio Gates. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line, and then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the old reliable, you're right, just one of 9 players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. On 1st and 10, Rivers. Right side catch. This is Gates. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Rivers now, the throw on 1st down. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. On 2nd down, Rivers again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Antonio Gates, the veteran tight end, was the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down. again, it's Rivers. Gates has it over the middle. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
And now the ball comes out. Manning lost it.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's the Giants with the football here as we begin quarter number two. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. They'll send Beckham alone to the left side. Manning gonna throw. Going up top. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there. But that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Here's Brad Wing now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And a fair catch is called for. He will take it in to give his guys some excellent field position here. And now San Diego getting set to go. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. It's a gain of 20 that time. And that'll be good for San Diego first down.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. One man in the backfield is Gordon. They go play action here on first down. His throw incomplete. He was looking for Travis Benjamin that time. And that'll bring up second down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
A second down throw for Rivers. Rush coming and he's taken down. Keenan Robinson coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And New York set to take the field. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. it's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. Now Manning throwing on second down, and his throw is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver, third down here.
I can hear the sigh of relief all the way up here. A dangerous throw, backed up in their own territory and throwing an out route, and it got jumped, and they were fortunate it was only batted down and not intercepted. I see an extra DB on the field now for San Diego.
Yeah, indeed. Now Manning. He's got Cruz complete. And he gets this one all the way up to the 40. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Charles, well, we have a second. We have to give a shout-out to Joe Thomas. It's been a tough year in Cleveland, but tell them what Joe Thomas accomplished.
He just played his 10,000th snap in a row without ever missing one in his career.
That's unbelievable.
His career. Not, I mean, lots. You get a lead. There could be a small injury. You know, your foot hurts for one play. Never has he come out of a game. Never has he missed a snap. An incredible Ironman record. And he's a perennial All-Pro left tackle.
A nickelback added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Corey Legion with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of seven. And now on is the field goal unit. And boy, this is speculative at best. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And this one will not work out. It is incomplete. They try the fake field goal. It doesn't work out. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And on second and 10 now. Rivers to throw it. Caught by Gates, left side. It's a gain of five on the play, and that'll bring up a third down. So a pause here for us as well. Time to pay some bills. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. Great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Throwing, Rivers, and incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
The return man here, Dwayne Harris. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to three. But this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Second down, here's Manning. And this one hauled in by Will Tye. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
To Shepherd, complete over the middle. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Manning now to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
For the field goal try, Robbie Gould. His career long, 58. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
And that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of halves.
He's got his man on the crossing route. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it.
Antonio Gates, and all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Antonio Gates, 42 yards. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. After the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now Manning throwing on second down. And now the ball comes out. Manning lost it. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Back near the goal line, here's Manning. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And they're going to try for the fourth down conversion. Manning and the offense staying put. They do go for it. It's Manning. He's going to let this one. Looking for Cruz, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jahleel Adai. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Final play of the half, Rivers. He's going to fire one deep over the middle and unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And all deep in his own territory, coughs up the football, and he takes it back to the house. It's a fumble recovery and a Charger touchdown. So they get the one score, kickoff, get a fumble, take it right back to the house. Two quick touchdowns within a matter of about 10 seconds on the game clock.
It's like a big 1-2 punch that may lead to a knockout.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. They go play action for Jennings. Now Manning. He's got time. Cruz has it over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. A very solid gain of 27.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll get it down here to the 43. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Again, it's Manning. It's his target, the tight end, Will Tye. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Throwing now is Manning. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Manning will try again on second down. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. And that'll make it third down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10. Throwing is Manning. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Yeah.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This from 54 yards away. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And oh, the gamble fails. It's incomplete. Charles, as we glance back at week 12 for a second, of all the games that were played, maybe that Chiefs-Broncos the most significant when you look at the playoff picture?
Most significant and maybe best played. I mean, think about all the excitement that went into that game, all the big plays, both sides having a chance to take control, Kansas City ultimately winning it. But Gary Kubiak, the head coach of Denver, his decision with about a minute to go to try the 62-yard field goal, that's the one that may come back because they had a chance to go ahead and take an overtime tie and put that on their record. Instead, it contributed to a loss.
Yeah, and it dropped the Broncos to 7-4. The Chiefs up to 8-3 behind the Raiders. Beckham, the lone receiver right. On first and 10, here's Manning. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
Back to the air on second down. It's Manning. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just drop to a point and react to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you end up covering him almost man for man. That allows him to make more plays on the football like the one we just saw there.
Use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Robbie Gould on for the extra point. And it's 17-7. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Chargers coming out of the field now. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Off the corner. Where'd he come from? Well, yeah, I mean, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he's a big factor in a run game. No gain.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for Antonio Gates that time, and it'll bring up third down.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Throwing, Rivers finds his target. It's Gates. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Whether it's Antonio Gates or not, Phillip Rivers loves the tight end position. He loves those throws. How about that route he just hit there?
Yeah, he's so good in this offense at weaving the tight end in, and sometimes the tight end helping him out, too.
Yeah, without a doubt. But how about how much he loves to play the game of football? Isn't it fun to watch him jawing back and forth with the opponents?
Absolutely.
I think that when he takes a big hit, it actually helps his game, gets him right into it. Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
And now a first down following that long gain. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll throw again. Rivers, he's got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Travis Benjamin from 3 yards out. And the Chargers are going to add on to their lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. And this should be the final. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. They go play action here on first down. He's going to air one out. And that's caught inside the 35. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's the Giants with possession of the football but needing points as we start quarter number 4. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Manning now on first down. Hits his target, the tight end, Will Tye. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys, we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Second down and just one. This is Jennings trying to run inside, but nothing there. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1.
So after that stop, you know that 3rd down is not a gimme if you're on the offensive team. So what are you going to do? Run it again, or maybe you go play action and try and throw the ball and pick up the necessary yardage.
And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Denzel Perryman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now San Diego getting set to go. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
10 yards still left on 2nd down. Again, we'll see the pistol here. throwing again. Rivers on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and breaks up third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. From the gun, Rivers. And the third down pass falls incomplete. Antonio Gates unable to hang on, and it's fourth down. Here's Drew Kazer now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. Harris now to return. 12 yards on the return that time. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The New York set to take the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
3 yards remaining here on second down. They'll send Beckham alone to the left side. Manning the throw on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. Manning going to try and throw on third down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Give him three on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. They come out here in the eye. Going with their tight end on fourth. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It'll be a 3 yard gain. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Throwing on first down is Manning. Over the middle to Beckham. And he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
One of the selling points of the end route is against the quarterback, a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a short gain here down to the 22. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8. On second down, here's Manning. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
To throw, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Adrian Phillips, and the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. And now San Diego getting set to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple, and hopefully flip the field.
Just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. San Diego. Griff Whalen, 82 yards. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead.
Partner, one of the cardinal rules of defense is that if you're in position to make a tackle, you need to make it.
Well, and if you can't make the tackle before that, you just got to knock that ball down, right?
Yeah, something has to happen because we saw the end result there. Missed tackle, he goes all the way and takes it for a touchdown.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And now out come the Giants. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Melvin Ingram, from his outside linebacker spot, he comes up to drop him for a loss of 10. Now Manning throwing on second down. And now here's another interception, picked off by Dwight Lowry. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. And now San Diego getting set to go. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. Any better feeling than being up big on the road?
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name it, all those things they had to deal with, they were able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one. Throwing here, Rivers. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to his tight end, Gates, and it's third down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Another pistol look here. On third down, Rivers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. They were looking to go back to Gates. And fourth down coming up.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Here's Josh Lambeau now for the Charger field goal. From the right hash, this from 53. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw, and his throw's going to be incomplete. Oh, and the defender took some liberties there with a late hit, roughing the passer.
The league has done a great job of defining what is a late hit and illegal contact on a quarterback. The defenders really have to get in line.
On first and 10, here's Manning. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Manning now on first down. Caught left side, it's Beckham. Give him eight on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Now the Chargers are going to look up here and signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. One receiver left, three to the right. Manning to throw on second down. And my goodness, another interception. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now San Diego getting set to go. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
He's going to float this one deep right side, and it's incomplete. And still throwing to the very end, but now this game is over. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gott. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from MetLife Stadium.